Watch my first episode. I appreciate you for that. This is my second episode, so this is gonna be interesting. So I got a little music playing in the background, you know, something more relaxing, because I love music, all kinds of music. It don't matter, as long as it sounds good, I love it. Nice beat, I love it. So we'll have the music playing in the background while I speak. So, for those who missed my first episode, it was just really about do's and don'ts when it comes to eating and not indulging in your food. So, I'm going to start with things that I forgot to mention in my first video. So, this one is going to be very brief. But at the beginning of me finishing off of my first video, I forgot to mention teas that I drink. I love yogi tea. I drink detox. I also drink this tea. This tea is good for your skin. It works. Trust me. And this is another tea that I drink. My number one tea that I love is green tea, of course, like I mentioned earlier. But the brand that I use is more so like your cold, chilled teas. But for hot teas, this is a good one. This is for weight loss. It burns like your fatty cells and things like that. This is a good one. This or green tea. So I like to go back and forth between the two. But I do a detox several times a week. And I drink this also several times a week to help with my skin. So, green tea. And for my sweetener, I use pure honey. I don't use sugar. Again, like I said in my first video, I use honey. And I don't use an abundance of it. I use a small amount of honey, just enough so I can smell it. And when I drink my tea, it has like a nice soothing, sweetened taste to it. It's not super sweet at all. So yeah. So this video, like I mentioned before, I was gonna do on how to start working out. If you are a person that is highly overweight, I'm not talking about going off the Merlin chart or the health chart, whatever that chart that they have that says, you know, if you weigh this certain amount, then you are, you know, overweight and you are at risk of these certain health conditions. I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about being overweight in the sense of certain clothes you fit don't fit no more. And let's all be honest. We know when we are becoming at that point where we like, look girl, I gotta lose weight. I can't even walk up a flight of damn steps without even, you know, losing my breath. I can't even run a half a block if I had to. That's when you know you're overweight, okay? So for those who cardio or who don't work out at all, I'm going to give you tips on how to start and things that I did with starting if I had my child. I started off with just cardio. I was so tempted to do the weights, but everything comes in due time. But when you first start working out, for those who are overweight, for those who probably just had a baby, when you first start working out, focus on just cardio. Like with me, when I was pregnant, I gained 60, 70 pounds when I was pregnant. So, and again, like I said, I was 210 pounds. I did nothing but cardio. I did my running. I did low to moderate running. I focused on my elliptical machines, walking up hills, anything that's going to make me just break out in a sweat and get that heart rate going. And that's what I did. I started off with doing 30 minutes of cardio. Running. If you're not good with running, if you have bad knees, I had surgery on one of my knees, so my knees are not that great. So I try to avoid doing a lot of stuff that's real, that's going to have a major impact on my knee. So if you're not good with that, you want to go back and forth. Like if you choose to do a treadmill, I suggest going back and forth between, if you choose not to run, walk uphill at a pretty good speed. 2.5 miles is my 2.5 miles. 2.5 is a speed that is a good speed to start off with. Anything less than that, it's okay, but you're not going to get the full result from that. If you want to start off slower than that, I would suggest doing that just for a week. Don't go past a week doing less than 2.5. For my max, try to get up to 2.8 to 3.0 speed within doing uphill walking. Go back and forth, alternate within your 30 minutes. Go between doing a minute of walking uphill and 30-second jog. Back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. If you want to spread it out longer, you're more than welcome to. You could do 2-minute walk with a 2-minute uphill walk with a 30-second jog. Whichever that you feel is more comfortable, for you. However, you don't want to get too much into your comfort zone because you want to challenge your body. Because if you don't challenge your body, you'll never advance within your workouts, and you want to advance within your results as far as the effect that the workout will have on your body. So you want to always try to advance. I would say move up whatever you're doing, increase it within that next week or 2 weeks. But don't go a whole month doing the same thing, because I'm telling you, it will not work. Your body will adjust, and it'll be just pointless. You want to keep challenging yourself and challenging your body. Again, like I said, I was running 1.5 miles when I first started. And again, prior to me having my child, like I said before, like I was already working out. So it wasn't as difficult, but I know for some it may be difficult for them. So, but this is, again, what my method that I use. I was running 1.5 miles. I did that 4 to 5 times a week. Twice a week ain't gonna cut it. Once a week, it's not gonna cut it. You need to make time and put in the work for you to be healthy. Again, this is not just about being fit or you know, looking good in your clothes. Again, that's a plus, it helps, but this is more so within your health. You know, we have like the virus and stuff that's going on that's affecting those who are overweight and affecting those who are not healthy. Those who may have bad eating habits that may, you know, switch over into you being diabetic or having like high cholesterol and things like that. So you want to, now is the time to start focusing on a better lifestyle for yourself. And for those who have children, you know, I'm sure you want to live, you know, a long life, so you can watch your children grow. You could be at their wedding or, you know, be there to spend time with your future grandchildren, things like that. So that's what I want people to start thinking about, and not just, you know, looking good. No, it's also about feeling good within yourself and being a better person for you. So again, 4 to 5 times a week, you want to make time for that. With me, when I work during the days, after I get off of work, I don't care how tired I am, I mentally prepare myself throughout the day that I'm going to work out. So therefore, throughout that day, I'm getting my vegetables in, I'm getting my salads in, I'm getting my protein in, I'm hydrating, I'm getting my water in. So I'm using, so my body is like a machine. You want to get it ready for the workout, basically. So you don't want to just, you know, be at work and eating unhealthy and then think that you're going to get off of work and then go to the gym and you're going to put in this good workout, because you're not, because your body, I'm telling you, you're going to overwork yourself, you're going to feel exhausted, and you're going to tire your body out a lot faster as opposed if you prepared your body for that workout. So I prepare my body for my workouts. No fried foods. During my workouts, my workout week, when I work out 5 days a week, I try to avoid, I do avoid bad foods, because it don't balance out when you're trying to work out and you're eating bad. So when I do treat myself, or, you know, and enjoy myself and eating, I like to do that on my off days. And then for 5 days straight, I am hitting it hard at the gym, and I'm eating right for those 5 days. And on my off days, it's not like I, you know, all right, this is my off day, I'm eating me a whole pizza, I'm going to drink me a Pepsi with it. For dessert, I'm going to eat me a fudge ice cream and stuff like that. No, that's not what I mean. What I mean is, on my off days, like, I'm going to show you a picture in this video of, for breakfast this morning, I ate three turkey bacons with scrambled eggs. You can put cheese in your eggs, but don't put too much of cheese in your eggs. I put scrambled eggs, and I ate one pancake, literally one pancake, and my pancake was about this size, with a nice glaze of syrup on it. I didn't drown it, put it on my eggs, put it on my bacon, put it all over the plate. No, I did not do that. So that was my way of eating healthy, but also adding in those sweets and those fats, because believe it or not, your body do need sweets and your body do need fats. But try to make those sweets be your healthy sweets, and those fats be your good fats. So that was my breakfast. What I'm gonna do for lunch or dinner, I haven't decided yet. So I'm not even gonna sit up here and stunt like I know what I'm gonna cook, because I have no idea what I'm gonna make today. But that was my breakfast. So 4 to 5 times a week, you wanna start getting in a hang of that. If you're an average person where you're not overweight, but you don't work out, and you want to tone your body, you want to, you know, get those, plump those glutes up, you want to, you know, thicken your legs, if you feel like you are, you know, lean or something, I don't know what your preference is, but within my workouts, I focus on toning, and I focus on abs, I focus on, I do arm workouts, I don't know if you can tell, but like, I have like my arms are like toning and stuff like that. You can see like right here, this crease is starting to form, because I do my arm workouts, I do back, I do everything. So again, you want to follow me on my workouts, feel free to do so on my Instagram. On my last video, I said that my Instagram was Miss Lady B. It's not. I changed it. It's actually miss.honey.b. And I'll add that on the end within, I'll put my IG name on here. And again, like I said, feel free to comment, leave your comments. I'm open to whatever you have to, whatever questions you have, and I will speak on it. Again, if you're average, you don't have to do cardio every single day, like I'm telling the people who are overweight or the people who need to lose a large amount of weight. If you're average like me, I'll do cardio, good cardio, twice a week. In between those days, or during those days, I do weight training. And in my weight training, again, like I said, it's so much different. It's so many different workouts that I do as far as my weight training. The only thing I suggest for that is just following my my workouts that I do to get a better idea. Because I can sit up here and say, yeah, I do, you know, 3 sets, you know, I use a 40-pound dumbbell and I do 12 reps each of good mornings. You know, some people not even gonna know what the hell I'm talking about. But if I show you, you'll pick up and you'll start to learn and knowing what I do, or actually doing what I do. I'm gonna put my music back on. So you wanna do your weight training. You wanna weight train. I do weights 5 days a week. Some people cannot do that. If you cannot do 5 days a week, it's okay. You can do 4 times a week. If you start doing anything less than 4, you really have to do like a strict diet, because it's not gonna work. That's why I personally go 5 days a week. Oh, again, I didn't speak on alcohol. If you're a person that love to drink hard liquor and stuff like that, try to slim that down, because alcohol has a lot of calories and it has a lot of sugars in it, and it will definitely go right here. So try to not intake a lot of alcohol. You know, get that down. Speaking of sweets, I don't buy sweets. When I go shopping in the market, at the market, I do not buy cookies, I don't buy cakes, I don't buy none of that, because let me tell you, if I buy it, I'm going to eat it. So avoid me not eating it, I just don't buy it. If we all have children, they all need their snacks, but try to get good snacks for your kids. With my son, I get him cups of fruit, like peaches, mixed fruit. I get him like crackers, cookies. If I give him cookies, I don't know if you guys ever saw it, but like it's like a container, like a small container, and it's like $1. I buy him that. I don't not buy him a whole pack of cookies. Absolutely not, because let me tell you, every walk I take past some cookies, I'm gonna be eating them. So I'm not even stepping in line. So to avoid that, I get him his own little small personal portion of his cookies. I don't buy sodas. I don't do sodas no more. I don't buy cases of sodas anymore, because if I don't buy it, I won't eat it. So yeah. So once you do better with not buying this stuff for your home, you won't even want it when you do go out, because most of us, we spend more time at home than we do at the restaurants, or than we, you know, do, you know, out for entertainment, where is this, the movies, because the movies is closed, so ain't nobody at the damn movies right now. So right now we spend more time at home. So if it's not in your house, good job. So within my workouts, my next video, I'm going to put up workout plans, and it's not going to be notes of what I do. It's actually going to be me working out from beginning to end. I'm going to put on there how long I work out, and I work out for about an hour and a half to 2 hours at the gym. I'm not expecting y'all to do that. If you want to, that's great, but you don't have to. Some people recommend 45 minutes to an hour. That's not really enough for me. At the minimum, I do 90 minutes. But for the average people, you want to do workouts such as uphill walking, because you want to get that resistance going. And as you're walking uphill, you pretty much are toning your whole lower body. And for those women who want to get nice glutes, want to get, you know, focus on your lower abs, tone your calf muscles, tone your quads and stuff like that, walking uphill is great. I walk at the max. Whatever that machine go on the incline, I put it at its max, and I walk at 2.8 at a 2.8 speed. And I do that for 10 minutes because I started doing that at the beginning of my workouts for 10 minutes. And then I do my weight training in the middle of that. And then at the end, I may do another 10 minutes doing an incline walk. So that gives me a total of 20 minutes. But I stopped doing it because I started to lean out and get like really small. And that's not what my goal is. Now, if you want to get small, you want to get real lean, you can do that. You can do your 20-minute cardio, 25-minute cardio if you want to be lean. If you want to be lean, you want to focus on doing a lot of cardio. If you want to be toned and gaining muscle, you want to focus on doing more weight training and less cardio. So that's the key factor. If you want to be more toned, like me, like what I'm trying to do and what my goal is, more toned and gaining muscle, you do not want to exceed no more than a 20 minute workout. But prior to you starting your weight training, you want to make sure that you get down to a weight that you feel is comfortable for you, and you feel like, damn, you know, I'm starting to look good in these jeans, I'm starting to look good in these pants, whatever. If once you get down to that where you can see that you are, you know, coming down, that's when you want to start your weight training. You want to start doing your weights. Again, I do the Stairmaster. Believe it or not, some people don't know, but on the Stairmasters and on those elliptical machines, all those machines have programs on there, and they may have like a fat loss mode. They may have intervals, hills, or rolling hills. Like, they have so many different programs. You want to not do too much of manual, because manual, you just doing whatever you choose that you want to do. And sometimes we don't know what the hell we're doing with that. We don't know what the hell we're doing. So I prefer to do intervals. I prefer to do whether it's a fat burning program or what. I do that and let the machine do its work as far as adding my resistance. Now, if I feel like let me rewind that. They have levels on there. So based on your level, that's how the machine is going to move you along that workout. So with me, all my machines now that I do is either, I was doing 6 to start off, because again, I was already kind of, you know, into working out. So I was going on level 6. Now I'm doing level 7 or 8. So again, like as I said, you want to challenge yourself. So once you start feeling comfortable with whatever level or whatever speed you want, don't be afraid. Do not be afraid. Do not feel like, but I don't want to do it because it may be too much. You will be surprised how much your body can really do if you push it. So once you start feeling comfortable with doing these exercises, challenge yourself. Increase that level. Increase it to go up 1, go up 2. And once you feel like, all right, this is good, focus on doing that for 2 weeks. Once you start feeling comfortable, 2 or 3 weeks. Once you start feeling comfortable with that, go up again. And the more you challenge yourself, the more you work your body, and the more your body will start to react to those changes. And you will start getting those results that you're looking for. So those are my cardios that I do when I go to the gym. Is my heels, elliptical machine with resistance to focus on, you know, getting my quads tight, getting my glutes tight, and getting my legs, my calf muscles tight. My weight training, I'm not gonna go into that. Like I said, I'll post videos and I'll be real descriptive in what I do, and you can follow me with that. So my next video that you're gonna see from me is gonna be getting into action, and we're gonna be working out. And again, with that working out, if you want to look back at my last video or this video to focus on what you do not eat, what you do eat, or what you can eat, what you can't eat. So you want to make sure within you watching my videos that you also are eating right or eating better. So that's pretty much it for today. I hope you guys are taking my tips down and writing them down and actually doing them. And I'm trying to tell you, if people are getting results, DM me your results and stuff like that. Cause I'm excited and I can't wait. And trust me, once that weight starts to fall off. Oh, one last thing, the scale. Do not focus too much on the scale, because that was where I made the mistake at when I first started working out prior to me having my child. I will be in the gym, working out, doing my squats and everything, and I get on the scale, and the scale said I gained like 2 or 3 pounds. And it was like, I felt like, you know, what the hell am I doing wrong? Because I'm in the gym and I'm working out, but every time I get on the damn scale, it's telling me I'm gaining weight. Don't focus on the scale, because the minute you start doing weight training, you are adding on muscle, and that muscle weight is going to show on that scale. So don't focus on the scale. What I do, or what I do suggest, is that you focus on get them pair of jeans that you got in your closet where you know it's a little struggle for you to fasten it. Get that jean out, or get that shirt out. When you put your arms in there, it's tight. You could practically button it and get it to button, or it's so tight that the damn button about to pop. Get that shirt out. Get those pants out. As you start your journey, keep regressing to that outfit or those pants or those dresses, and you'll see the difference within your clothes. So that's what I suggest, and that's my last tip for today. Enjoy your weekend, enjoy your day, be safe, and again, tune in next, because my next video is going to be my workouts, and that's it.